Thanks for being here. My name is Alan Cox. Welcome. High fives, Mr. and Mrs. America. And we're off. Say hi to Bill Squire. He's right over there.
Hey, creepy hugs, everyone. Thanks for listening to and watching this episode of the Alan Cox Show. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and share a cold one with the boys.
There's Mary Santora.
Yo, what up?
I think I got to redial Poundcake up. Hold on, Cody. I did some last-minute hubbubaloo in here. I got you there?
Yes, I can hear you.
There we go.
All right, make sure we can hear him, though, on the live stream.
Poundcake is back there in Studio G.
Let me make sure.
All the buttons are pushed.
Yeah, after new white people. I don't know what happened. Literally before the showtime. I can hear you great.
No, I did that.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it wouldn't let me.
We had to reset some stuff.
I had to reset some stuff in here. And
gotcha.
That reset my board. So anyway, all behind the curtain stuff. Who cares? Welcome, everybody. If you'd like to join us, you can do it on the telephone. It's 216-578-1007 or 800-348-1007. You can leave messages on the iHeartRadio app. And you can text, if you like, 35192. I heard somebody referring to, I'm sure it was someone in the sales department, I heard someone referring to the talk back button on our iHeartRadio app as the new phone call. Like, no, phone calls are still phone calls.
Right.
I still like taking phone calls.
I took phone calls on my podcast for the first time last night.
How did that go?
It went pretty well. We had some people. So there's this kid that saw me at a show in Erie a couple weeks ago, and he was our first call. He was also a former Mormon, so he talked about his experience. He's black.
A Mormon?
Yeah, so he's black and was Mormon, and so that was like a whole different. He had a very different experience as a Mormon than I did.
So wait a minute. There was
they didn't
racism?
Even let him in until 1971.
There's racism within the church?
Oh, yeah.
I know that sounds crazy to say that because whatever, but you would think if you're Mormon, they're like, congrats,
well,
you're one of us.
So here's the thing. There was this time, they have this thing called the priesthood, where it's like, that means you're like an ordained member of the church. And they wouldn't let black men have that.
Oh, wow.
Because they were black.
Wow.
And they changed that in the 70s. And they're like, oh, it was just like God tested. You know, they have their crappy explanation for everything. But it was straight up racism. But they eventually changed it. But it's still not good. And then my niece called in. And she got very mad because we kept saying she was only 3 years old. And she's like, I'm seven. and a few other people.
It's a very important distinction to make. Yeah. You know, when you're a kid, you want to be older. And then you get older and you want to be a kid.
Mm-hmm.
Although the Mormon church has come out and said that they support all the same-sex marriage laws.
Laws.
Same-sex marriage laws. It's hard to say. Especially in the context of the Mormon church. But they have voiced their public support for that. So I guess the thought being even gays should get their own planets. Is that how that works?
Well, that's a huge move for them because
that's what I'm saying.
They fought when gay marriage was being legalized in states like 2004, 2005, 2006 time. They were one of the biggest advocates against it.
Sure, yeah.
They're
probably spending a lot
yeah.
of their largesse on trying to get those laws,
which is a shame,
returned.
They have like some of the hottest men.
The hottest.
Like a Derek Huff.
Is he a Mormon?
Yeah.
Oh,
or Latter-day Saint, yeah.
Yeah. And I'll tell you what, boy, that's a real pat on the back, isn't it? To call yourself a Latter-day Saint.
Mm-hmm.
I like that a lot. I mean, there's a lot of religions. You don't usually refer to yourself. You know, when you grow up Catholic, you're taught that you're a worm. You're dirt. You're nothing. You're lucky to even be here. Your knees should be bloody all the time in constant supplication to the God who gave you life. There's a prayer in the Catholic Church. Do not consider what I truly deserve. The implication being nothing. You should suffer and burn and scream for all eternity. But God is, man, he's looking out for you. You're in luck. Mormons, they went right to, I'm a Latter-day Saint, yo. Alan, is today a global broadcast event? It is indeed,
it is indeed.
A global
Who's helping out?
Broadcast stream, just like, what's her name? Panic at the Disco.
Mm-hmm. Her.
Who is helping out today on the live stream? Let me take a look very quickly. Bucket Ducks Nut is helping out today. Hey, thanks, sir, madam. latest episode of the Poundcake.
I think it's pronounced duck snut.
Duck snut.
Yeah, duck snut.
Bucket duck snut. Latest episode of the Poundcake podcast is up there for you as well. It's called Don't Frown While Wearing a Crown. Let me guess. It's more about crowns than frowns. It's about the show The Crown.
Correct.
Nailed it. Is it a guest or is it you pontificating on the royal family?
Is it an hour? Is Dustin going to be okay with it?
No, probably not. It's a half hour.
Okay.
Oh.
It's a half hour. It's just like my rundown.
Now it's Dustin. Poundcake's not. He don't do in 5 minutes now. I don't get it.
I'm going to do it.
Here in Georgia. I want to hear more than that. And who could blame him, quite frankly? So, yeah. Poundcake is, by the way, and again, it's a big show, I guess. The Crown's very popular. You're the only person I know who's wearing it. I can't talk to
you. You are on one day.
What's going on?
I'm the same way.
I can't. It's because I didn't sleep last night. You're the only person I know who's watching that show.
I'm the only person you know openly saying that they're watching
Well, no, it's a popular show. Why would anybody hide watching The Crown?
Because it's just like... I don't know. It's not appointment watching for everyone.
No, but there's no reason somebody would lie. People watch awful television and they're very proud of it. I can't imagine anybody lying about watching The Crown.
I know some people that talk it. You guys pass it to me that watch it.
Yeah.
I think everyone knows how it ends and like what's going to happen. So I guess it's not a big deal for most people. But for me, I was never like a royal family fanatic. I really didn't care that much. It was just a bunch of rich white people, snobby, and
but now you love them.
No, I love the drama behind it.
Well, yeah, but that's why people love it too. They don't really love the people.
The history.
They love the drama. No one's really like, oh, I just want them to be happy and healthy. No,
it's bigger.
People want to see the drama. They want to.
It's bigger than that. Yeah. It's the fact that they can trace their ancestors back. You know, hundreds, if not thousands of years.
Yeah, unfortunately, it's a straight line.
Okay, but like the fact
that... banging each other.
I mentioned this in the podcast. The fact that Camilla, you know, her great-grandmother was a side piece. Her great-grandmother was a hoe. She was the mistress to King Andrew or whatever his name was. And the fact that that hoe has literally gone down the line and now has become queen, that's a model.
Well, she's not queen.
Queen consort. I don't care what you
say. Yeah, consort.
She
doesn't get the title of queen.
She married a king. I don't care. She's queen, as far as I'm concerned.
She just K-W-E-E-N.
She said, there's just a little thing we got to get out of the way. Her name's Diana.
Wow. I mean, she was the Duchess of, what was Diana? Princess of Wales?
Princess of Wales.
She wasn't Of course, I guess he wasn't the king then, so she wouldn't have been queen. Yeah. But again, I don't think she would have been queen.
I mean, it goes by bloodline, so she technically wouldn't have any power. But the fact that the queen, Queen Elizabeth, did not even want Camilla in her sight. She was a side piece. She was a roach. She was a floozy, if you will.
A woman of ill repute.
Now she's on the balcony waving at all the commoners. She's like, I went from hoe to queen.
Is from what?
Hoe to queen.
Oh, I thought he said hoe.
I did too. Courtney Love's got nothing to do with this. Hey, is there anybody on that show, The Crown, who plays the Dirk of Worcestershire? Did they cast that part over there? That would get me watching the show.
Made a cameo.
Yeah. Okay. Nothing can stop you. Gotta take a break.
As a shire.
Yeah.
You are my girl, and no one can hurt you. Oh, no.
Hey, I found this guy. He's like the Duke of Ayrshire or something.
Oh, boy, I'll tell you what. History got nothing on him. I got to take a break here. If you'd like to text for anything, 35192 to get me there. You can, of course, leave messages on the iHeartRadio app, and we'll be back after these.
It's the Alan Cox Show. On Alfred.